With the final week of the Premier League approaching this Sunday at 11 o'clock, we still have so many positions left that are being fought for. There are spots in the Champions League, Europa League, and even the relegation is not confirmed yet. So there are just a bunch of games that we're going to be discussing today about the Premier League this Sunday. The first game we're going to be talking about today is a pretty crucial one. Two teams fighting for spots, it's Chelsea and Wolves. Chelsea right now are in fourth place, tied with Manchester United with 63 points and just 1 point ahead of Leicester. And Wolves are a point ahead of Tottenham for Europa League. So this is a big game for both teams. And I think, unfortunately for Wolves, Chelsea is at home, and all Chelsea need to advance to the Champions League is a tie. And I just don't see a situation where they don't get what they need. I think Chelsea have at least a tie lined up for them at Stamford Bridge against Wolves. I just think Wolves could suffer greatly from this.
Yeah, I definitely agree. I think the only factor that really matters here is Christian Pulisic's health. I think if Pulisic is healthy, then I think Chelsea should definitely be able to get what they need. He's been a star for them. You saw what happened when he came on in the second half against the champions Liverpool. So I think he will be healthy. I think Lampard will start him, and I think that means Chelsea will win 2-1, in my opinion.
Yeah, for sure. I probably can't give you an exact scoreline, but I think it'll be pretty similar to that. Again, as you said, Christian Pulisic, a huge player for Chelsea since the restart. Last game, I think it was yesterday, the day before, against, I think it was yesterday, on Wednesday, Liverpool was beating Chelsea up pretty bad, and then Pulisic came on and made an immediate impact, scoring a goal and an assist. And also assisting a Tammy Abraham goal.
He got past four defenders on that one.
And that was a just phenomenal skill on the ball. And that's just a crucial aspect of this Chelsea team since the restart. Now, for Wolves, this game does not matter if and only if Chelsea are able to beat Arsenal in the FA Cup final on August 1st. Arsenal are in 10th place right now. They don't have enough points for a Europa League spot. However, if they do win the FA Cup, they are guaranteed automatically be getting in a Europa League spot, and they'll either be replacing Wolves or Tottenham for that spot. If Arsenal lose, however, Wolves and Tottenham both are in the Europa League.
Now we go on to our next game, Leicester against Manchester United. I think this is one of the biggest games, if not the headline game, probably the headline game of the entire of the week, maybe the headline game of the year, honestly. It's basically a Champions League playoff. That's what they've been saying. And it basically is. If Man United win, they're in. If Leicester win, they're in. This will be a very interesting game. I'm very nervous for Leicester as a fan of Leicester. So I think it's going to be a tough game. But they're at the King Power Stadium. And I feel like, even though there are no fans, I feel like there's a weird still that home teams tend to win more than away teams. It's weird. So I don't know. Maybe that'll have some sort of effect. I feel like Man United, the last two games against Chelsea in the FA Cup and West Ham in the Prem, they didn't look as good as they did. Like, players like Bruno, Pogba, they all didn't look as sharp. Especially Pogba with that handball against West Ham, and which led them to get their only goal. But West Ham played a good game overall, which really Man United didn't look great. I feel like still Leicester was much worse when they lost 3-0 to Tottenham. So obviously not going to be cakewalk for either team. I think, in my opinion, there will be. I think it's going to be a 1-1 draw, because I think both teams are kind of on that even playing field. Man United may be a little bit better, but Leicester are at home, so I feel like 1-1's accurate scoreline, which will mean Chelsea and Man United will go through to the Champions League. Charlie?
Yeah, I agree mostly. I think Leicester are not looking good right now. We thought they turned it around after that win against Sheffield, but then went right back around and lost 3-0 to Tottenham. However, Man United aren't looking that much better. They tied West Ham 1-1 with a goal from Antonio on a penalty for West Ham at the end of the first half. Mason Greenwood was able to equalize. He's a really great young player. Just as Man U's attack is just excellent. They're really prolific scorers. they convert a lot of their chances. However, after that 3-0 loss to Chelsea in the FA Cup semifinals, I'm just not sure what that back line and De Gea are capable of. De Gea let in 3 goals, and although Chelsea dominated that game and deserved to win, none of those goals really deserved to go in. Mason Mount's shot from probably 20-25 yards out went off of De Gea's hands and into the goal on the ground. And then Maguire scored an own goal for the 3rd goal. So I just, Man United, neither team has been looking impressive lately. But realistically, I'm going to agree with you. I think a 1-1, maybe 2-2 tie. I just can't see Leicester scoring that many goals. I don't know. But it's definitely possible. 1-1 tie, also my prediction. But moving on, here's a game that does count. West Ham hosting Aston Villa. West Ham, fortunately for them, have just barely avoided relegation, but Aston Villa are still on the bubble. Right now, they are hovering just above that limit. They're 17th right now, but they are tied with Watford, and they only have a +1 goal differential over Watford. And playing a team like West Ham, who doesn't have anything to play for, but West Ham was just able to get that tie against Man United. So I don't know if West Ham are starting all their key players, but we know one thing for sure, Aston Villa will be. So I think my guess is probably a tie, just because West Ham are at home and the better team. However, Aston Villa do have something to play for, so I think Aston Villa will maybe be able to get that tie.
Yeah, I think West Ham probably are playing better football as of late, but I still think that, honestly, they have nothing to play for. They just clinched from non-relegations, and Aston Villa are still, like you said, on that bubble. So I feel like while Watford has nothing to play for, Aston Villa are going to fight for their lives, and they're fighting for their lives, and they're going to play like it. It's going to be a very good game, Aston Villa being especially hungry side, and West Ham want to end up the year on a good note. So I think 2-2. 2-2 would be an interesting game, but I think, yeah, it ends in a draw.
Yeah. Moving on, though, this is a game that does have effect. Arsenal hosting Watford. I think Arsenal, much better team here. However, Arsenal doesn't have anything to play for until that August 1st game against Chelsea in the FA Cup final. So this game is unimportant to them. It doesn't affect where they are in terms of Europa League. However, Watford are right now in 18th place. They are on the bubble for relegation. If they can win this game at Arsenal, which I think there's a very slim chance of, I think they'll probably move on. They just need to have a better result than Aston Villa, who right now they're tied with, a little bit worse, just one goal worse on goal difference. So if Watford are able to win the game by 2 goals, even if Aston Villa tie, if Watford are able to win with an Aston Villa tie, they move on. However, I don't think Watford will win this game. I think at the very least it'll be a tie, but I do have Arsenal winning this one, maybe 2-0.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. I think Watford haven't really been a great team this year. I think it was a very dumb decision by the owners to stack Nigel Pearson towards the end of the year when they have key games coming up and switch to a totally different approach, which wasn't very, in my opinion, a very good idea. I agree. Arsenal, clearly superior team. Watford, another team. They'll be fighting for their lives. But Arsenal, really under the radar. They've really improved under Arteta as he's continued to manage this team. They have nice players like Pepe, Bakayoko, Aubameyang, Lacazette. They've got great attacking players. I think 3-1 at the Emirates.
But moving on, a game that matters. Crystal Palace are hosting Tottenham. Tottenham right now are in 7th place, just 1 point behind Wolves. And you would think that 5, 6, 7 get automatic Europa League spots. But as we discussed earlier, Arsenal, if they do beat Chelsea in that FA Cup final, this is just a key game, then they replace whoever is in 7th place for that Europa League spot. And right now, Tottenham is that team in 7th place. I, again, see Chelsea coming out with a win over Wolves, which leaves Tottenham to whatever they need. A tie, as long as Wolves lose, is enough to give them a for sure, a guaranteed Europa League spot, because they are just 1 point behind and one, and they have a better goal difference than Wolves. So I do think that Tottenham are the better team here, and they will come out on top, maybe in a close game, 2-1.
Yeah, I think I agree with you there. I think Palace, they've been an average team, pretty not good without Zaha. They're basically a one-man team. Tottenham have looked very good under Mourinho recently, with wins over teams like Leicester, Newcastle, Arsenal. They've been playing very well. I think they'll end it that way. I think I agree with you. Similar scoreline, maybe 3-1. I'd say. I think Tottenham. And now moving on to our final game, Everton versus Bournemouth. So by this point, based on both of our predictions, Bournemouth is already eliminated because Aston Villa have tied. I think
2-2 draw.
They're already relegated. Sorry, not eliminated. But so basically, this game has nothing to play for. Two rather disappointing teams. I like Eddie Howe. He's a good manager. I feel like it won't take much time for Bournemouth to come back up. But I feel like Everton. I feel like it's not their time right now. Everton, another team that hasn't played very well. 11th in the table. I think they have too good of a squad to be placing there. So in this game, it's not going to be a very fun game to watch. I think Everton maybe squeak out a 1-0 win over Bournemouth. What do you think?
Yeah, I think Everton's the better team, and especially at Goodison Park. I don't think it's a competition. Bournemouth haven't won a game since, I believe, February, which is not good. They haven't won since February 1st in a 2-1 game against Aston Villa. And even since then, they've only tied one game. They've tied two games, but have not won since February 1st. Bournemouth is a very bad team, I think it's safe to say right now. Clearly, they must have started off the season with a little bit of pep, but like maybe towards the middle of the pack, but after losing, or after not winning for probably at least 10 games in a row since February, they're just not a very good team right now, and Everton's a much better squad. Everton's going to be winning this game. I don't know how close it'll be, but maybe a one-goal, two-goal difference. That'll wrap it up for today. So Surridge thinks that Arsenal will be getting their Europa League spot. I do not, but that'll wrap it up for today. There are our Premier League predictions for the end of the year, and make sure to drop a like down below. Subscribe if you haven't already. Turn on notifications so that you never miss a video. Leave comments. We love to hear what your guys' opinion on the Champions League, Europa League, and relegation are right now. And any video ideas. We'll see you guys later.